So what's up guys, how do you do? Welcome to the edition Programming Wizards TV. In this class we're going to look at React installation. Okay, so in the previous class we actually introduced React. Okay, and of course in this class now it's now time to install React locally so that we will can be using it of course to create our projects. Okay, so React, of course, let's first start by a simple introduction to React. So introduction for those people who don't know what React is. Well, React of course is a front end. Okay, we can actually call it a front end library developed by Facebook. Okay, it was developed I think all the way back in the year 2013, and of course is used of course to construct user interfaces. Okay, so yeah, that's of course what React is. Now React of course it allows us to create reusable components. With React we create reusable components. Okay, that's actually how React works. It's actually a component based framework. Okay, so we create these reusable UI components. These are UI components, and then these components later on we compose them together to make of course a full user interface. Okay, so it's actually a component based frameworks. Right now I think it's probably one of the most, it's actually one of the most JavaScript libraries, and in fact in terms of the UI frameworks I think it is the most one. Okay, it is the most popular front-end library as of the time of recording this one. Okay, so that is React right there. Of course is actually what we're going to look at. Okay, now let's now proceed over and then talk about installation of React. So we'll come right here and say installation. Okay, so React installation. So of course the easiest way to install React is actually to use what we call a starter kit. Okay, in for that one we're going to create of course a starter kit. Okay, so it's, we call it create React app, is actually the best way for us to build a new React single page. So we're going to create a single page application, and of course so we'll use a starter kit. Okay, so you'll use a starter kit to install our React. This is the best, easiest way right here. It's so easy, and of course this is actually going to set up our environment. Okay, so this will set up our environment of course so that we can of course use the latest JS JavaScript features. Okay, so we can use the latest JavaScript. Now for this to be, for us to be able to do this one, of course you'll need an node.js of course greater than or equal to version 6 on your machine. Okay, so you'll need to have it installed. So I want to go into node.js installation. Please, you can refer to the node.js website and then install node.js. okay, so if you install it now it will definitely be greater than 6. So yeah, that's all we need. Now of course you can fire up your command prompt. I'm using Git. Okay, so Git, I'd recommend it. You can also download it from online, Git right here. And then of course once you have it, then you can to install our stuff. This is actually the command. Let's just write the notes. Okay, so okay, so in your terminal, in your, so let me just you want to use a note taking approach. So the first one is fire up your terminal. So in this particular case I'm going to use the Git. So I'm using the Git Okay, now once you fire it up, then type the following command. So we're going to have right here npm install, okay, then g to mean that you are installing it. We're actually installing it globally, okay, globally in our machine, so that we'll be reusing it. We won't be having to reinstall it again every time for every project that we create. So npm install j, then this one, let me have it as bash, so as the language. Then of course we come and say create React app, okay, that's all we need, create React app. Then of course we close this one. So this is actually the command, okay, copy paste this one, npm install g dash create React app, okay. So have it right there in your terminal. Now once you have that one, then of course we'll come and then create the project. Let me just say this, okay, so create the project. So to create the project, you're going to have the following command right here, so bash, then I'm going to have right here create React, then app, then of course you give it your app name, okay. So I'm going to call mine Hello World, okay, so I'll call it Hello World. Yeah, so that's what you type. So create React app, and then of course your app name, your application name. So that's all we need. So let's go and then execute those particular commands to actually see what we're getting. So of course, as we said, the first one is to come right here, npm install, and then we come in right here and then have it. So I'm going to have it right there. Then of course you are going to need an internet connection for this one, okay. So React is actually going to be downloaded and installed, okay. So it will take less than a minute to install right here, okay. You can clearly see it has added 67 packages, okay. So once our stuff is installed, all we need now is to come and then create our project, create React app, then Hello World, okay. So we did that one, then enter. You can see we're having an error. So actually what we need to do, this one we were getting, we're not permitted, okay, this is because of permission. So what you need to do, just close your Git bash or whatever you're using, and then restart it, right click, and then open as administrator. You run it as an administrator, okay. We use the administrator privileges to do that one. So I've restarted mine, opened it now, I've run it as an administrator, and clearly you can see it's actually installing the packages that we require, okay. So it's installing React, React DOM, and then the React scripts. So just make sure that before you actually, in your Git bash or whatever terminal you're using, you run it as an administrator. Now to do that one, you just right click and then run it as administrator, so that you have the administrator privileges to install the packages, okay. Okay, so as you can see guys, it's actually taken some time, quite a bit of time, but of course you can see it's successfully installed our stuff right there, okay. Now you can actually see, yeah, okay, and then for me you can see the folder in which they are installed. So we have it right here. If I open my folder, of course React right here, okay. So you can see then I'm having my Hello World right here, and then several node modules have actually been installed, okay. So yeah, that's what I'm having right there. So here is my Hello World project, which has already been installed for us. So what we can just do is cd into the Hello World, okay, we change directory into it, then npm start to start our development server. So as you can see, it's actually starting my development server right there, and of course it's actually opening it in a browser. Okay, so you can see right here I'm having, of course, my app. Okay, this is our first application, our start application, which has been created for us. Okay, so you can actually see right here the our Hello World React app, as it has actually been served and automatically shown right here in my browser. Okay, so as all we need to do is just to go to our src/app.js to save and then reload. So that's exactly what I'm going to do. I'm going to src my source folder, and then of course app.js. I'm going to open it with my Visual Studio Code. Okay, so I open it so that we can edit it and then save, and then you're going to see it being automatically reloaded. Okay, so yeah, here you have it right here. Okay, so as you can see, this of course is my project. Let me just close this one. Okay, so what we're going to do, I'm going to change the message. We're going to call it, of course, first application. Okay, that's our app title, and then I'm going to say, okay, let me give it something. For example, let's say that I want to create an application for web app for showing some tips. Then you're going to say, of course, is the coldest place in the universe. Okay, so this is my first tip right here. So all I need to do is to come then save. Okay, now once I've saved my application, then you can clearly see it's being automatically reloaded. I've not even reloaded it, so you can clearly see, guys, this is our very first application in, of course, React.js right here. So we're going to continue exploring more examples and also covering the components and also other concepts in React in more detail. So go ahead, subscribe to our channel ProgrammingWizards TV, and check our website https.campusha.info, and take care. I'll catch you in the next class.